People claim aphrodisiacs come in a variety of colors and flavors. Or do they? How you doing? I'm Trace. This is D News. The idea of an aphrodisiac has been tantalizing the human imagination for hundreds of years. Cobra blood, tiger penis, components of whale vomit. We will pretty much try anything in search of just the right sexy substance to turn us on. Unfortunately, even after centuries of trying, there's no compelling evidence that any of them could be responsible for more than just placebo effect. By definition, an aphrodisiac is something often thought to be a food or a drug that raises libido or sexual desire. The creation of desire by consuming something makes it sound like a love potion, right? That's how science sees it too. Arousal, desire, and motivation for sex are the result of a complicated chemical system composed of many parts. So being turned on means that something or someone activated the right balance of brain chemicals to drive sexual desire. That's not easy to do with a food, or a potion, or a pill. According to the FDA, there is no such thing as an aphrodisiac drug. In fact, earlier this year, they released a document that stated labeling claims for aphrodisiacs for over-the-counter use are either false, misleading, or unsupported by scientific data. The best we can do are prescription drugs like Viagra and Addy, which are used for the treatment of sexual dysfunction. But the studies show that while Viagra can be effective for patients who are experiencing sexual problems, it doesn't produce any sexy feelings in people who don't have a problem getting it up. Aphrodisiac, it ain't. And for women, who are often ignored in academic studies of sexual behavior, there is no data on non-prescription use of these drugs at all. But outside of the pharmaceutical realm, what about household or street items claiming to make me want to leave the one I'm with and start a new relationship with you? Science ruins the mood there as well. In fact, a review in Pharmacognosy Review concludes that none of the many dozens of herbal so-called aphrodisiacs used in Eastern and tribal medicines are 100% safe to use, nor proven to work in humans. Another study in Sexual Medicine Reviews of more common aphrodisiacs for Western cultures was similarly unmoved. Chocolate? Nope. It's correlated with increases in serotonin, but not connected to libido. Oysters? Nah. They have zinc, which is good for producing testosterone, but don't increase libido. Honey? There are no studies on its successful effects. And mad honey, found in Eastern Europe and the Middle East, can cause a tingle in the vagina, but that's just a toxin called granatoxin, which can cause heart issues. Tingles are not equal to libido, and that brings us to Spanish fly. It causes irritation of the urethra, the tube inside of the penis, because Spanish fly comes from ground-up blister beetles. The blisters are thanks to another toxin called cantharidin, also, again, not libido, more like Viagra. It might give men an erection, but erections aren't equal to arousal or desire. There are many, many, many studies on these substances, but each comes back with words like promising, or they'll simply call out the failure of safety or rigorous scientific controls. In the end, there is no evidence to support the effectiveness of chemical aphrodisiacs or sexy foods, but when it comes to sex, that actually doesn't matter. There may still be a scientific reason that you feel turned on after, for instance, eating oysters. There is scientific evidence that visual stimuli can have a powerful effect on sexual arousal. So a snack of oysters or bananas, which physically resemble sexual organs, might be enough to do the trick, or visiting a Georgia O'Keeffe gallery. On top of that, there is, of course, the placebo effect, one of our favorite things. Like in some cases, sexual desire, it's connected to social status, which is why it's not a surprise that rich people are often thought of as more attractive. But status can also be connected to something like oysters, which are pricey, or hard to obtain exotic material like penises of endangered animals or Spanish fly. Meaning, simply thinking some substance is rare might make you feel a certain way and you get all hot and bothered. The mind, apparently, is the only known aphrodisiac. We'd like to thank our sponsor, K Jewelers, for helping us make this episode. For 100 years, every kiss begins with K. And look, if you really want to increase sexual desire, maybe just go dance. Quit being such a downer and get on the dance floor. Science says it helps, and here's why. What do you think about aphrodisiacs? Tell us in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more D News, and thanks for watching.